Stokehaunted.
There is something across the room. Are you able to do that when you're on this side? There's lots of nerves. Are you able to lift the snag yet? That's all we're needing for, is to find out what you can do if you're in there. Looking in.
The truth is now there.
Can you lift things? Can you throw them?
The dog will eat it like you did. What's the matter?
Make noise, please. Can we see you? What do you look like?
Can you see
the dog?
Do you think you'd be able to recreate the images that you're seeing?
The smallest, the original development of Stafforshire was a banner castle in the earth. It was wiped down by the Nellis Point of the river and the worship. So that's how it goes from the state of the Stafforshire and so forth.
Didn't Nicky say that this is where they're part of the museum collection? Was probably
a couple hundred yards down the bench to what would have been the oldest part. There's not implausible that something here many, many hundreds of years ago.
Yeah, there's, by the looks of the light, they've got the lighting in here, there was obviously some kind of exhibition here. I wonder if this is where they've had some artifacts, probably old Stafford.
Is this one that says art gallery?
Yeah, if they've had some artifacts or something.
If there is, there's something with a strong attachment, but it's only this end of the building feel like this, nowhere else in the building.
Oh, sugar.
Do you think it's actually still here, Matt, or is it just...
Yeah, no, it's definitely still here. It's like a walk into it. It's like from walking into clear space to walking into a cloud, it's that much of a comparison.
So it's not something that's like replayed over and over. It's
no. It's as daft as it sounds.
Do you want this seat and then you can kind of hang it?
It's
really silly.
It's like a tangible.
It sounds
reality.
Really silly, but you can
walk it too. That's how it feels too.
I'm alright.
And is it? See where they've got them like steam. Well, obviously spotlighting there. Is it predominantly there, or is it where you are now?
Excuse me. It's the further I get to the centre of the building, the more it is.
So it could be even more
that
way.
Yeah, it could be.
The church is there, isn't it?
What is that?
The
church.
So it isn't going to be completely unheard of that there could be burial here.
Yeah, the old script of the church
as well. Because where there's churches, there's normally bodies. I didn't know.
It wasn't that far past the
door either.
Come on, I'll go sit in there.
Alright, you were sitting there.
What?
That's the year behind you, isn't
it? Are you recommending against it or?
No.
What did you hear?
Just, do you know someone's got new shoes on in the creek?
Yeah.
Sounded like, yeah, leather creaky shoes just inside. They weren't far in the doorway, I would have thought.
Just like a scratching noise on the side of metal, like a metal carrier. So I went to look at them, but they're wooden, they're not metal.
It being shown this side of this building being hit by lightning. I'm not sure why, or what relevance it has. Unless it's the spire of the church, but it's been hit by lightning.
Okay. Yeah. Ian, do you want to say what we're doing in here while the rest of the team are in the other room?
Yeah, basically we've come back into this room where we've recently been in because it's the same old story again. We've been asking shouting out in both rooms. When we were shouting out in here, we were hearing those in the adjacent room where the main team are now. Obviously we've been shouting out in there and now we're hearing noises and bumps and bangs in this room. So we've just come in here basically to sit quietly.
Divide and
conquer. See if we can pick up anything that's going on.
System of divide and conquer. We have a lot to learn from you if you'll just let us. So if you're in this space with us now, could you do something within this room that tells us you're here? Or if you're in the adjacent room, in this space with us now, could you do something within this room that tells us you're here? Or if you're in the adjacent room, could you do something within this room that tells us can you do something for them, please?
Yeah, pull one down and drop one, not on anybody in particular, just drop one to the ground so he can see that it's something that we can't do.
There's definitely a pull. There's a lot of energy in here. It's as though the energy can't at the moment fall. It's as though it wants to take shape and form into something, and it isn't. I don't think there's any one particular spirit as such. It's more like an energy.
You say it's like a soup of...
Yeah, it's more like a glute, a bit like a bit. If a lot of energy and a lot of different things all mixed together.
That made you jump.
I didn't want to get tongued then, that was all. So basically, it's just a big mixture of stuff. I think that's what Matt may have been picking up. But I know soon when I walked from, when I was at the far corner earlier on, and I walked down the room, it felt like I was walking through fog almost.
From to all, the area at the very bottom where we were.
So,
I think it's a bit like a new building syndrome, to be honest with you. I've been in buildings before when they've not been investigated. Sometimes you find that you can pick up on spirits, but it doesn't know how to communicate with you, it doesn't know how to manifest itself. It takes a couple of visits to it to get used to it before it actually works.
Would you say it's also a trust type of issue?
Yeah, definitely.
Oh, sounds like the dog's going.
Definitely.
Or is that, could that door close quite easily, or have you wedged it open, Sarah? There's a door at the end of the room. Could you close the door? Right at the far end of the room, there's a door.
Going on a prior experience that we've had, I think at least twice before with dogs being with us. Obviously two different dogs, not the same dog. I think it very much depends on JJ. You know, we don't know JJ. Obviously, Jonathan knows JJ, and the other people that are sort of a regular that know him and know what his nature's like. And it's interesting to see when things happen that he doesn't normally do. Then that's where the difference is. I think if it was some, because we don't know the dog at all very well. You know, the dog could just be normal behaviour for that particular dog. I think it's when it's doing stuff that isn't its normal behaviour, that's when it becomes quite useful. And in the past, we have had a situation with the dogs where, for example, you know, I was going back to when we investigated the dog cow in Telford, where we asked the dog to actually go to where the particular spirit was, and sure enough, it went to the exact chair where we'd been told the spirit is supposed to be sat in. The other time, of course, was at the Cricketer's Arms in Sandbach, where the dog was actually barking at where the spirit supposedly was and was following the spirit around the room.
So with a new animal that we obviously don't know the behaviour patterns of, would you say it's as much a measure of his reactions as it is to those around him that know him?
Yeah.
I think it's important to point out that JJ's actually a guide dog.
Yeah.
So
yes, importantly.
Ian?
Yeah?
So, something's happened to Les, I'm going to know. I don't know if somebody's come over or what. She's wide awake. She's wide awake but not responding to anything.
Seen this before.
Come on, back to me, Liz. Come on. Liz, come back. Come on, back to me. Now, please. No, you're not, Lizzie. Come on, back.
Get back.
Now. The spirit has just taken over, Liz. Can you please step back?
Don't look me face.
Okay. You back with me?
Yeah, well, eyes are glazed over by the looks of it.
Give us a grunt, Liz.
Mind your head, Sarah.
Step back. Liz?
Come on, Lizzie. Thank you. Okay, you're back now. Come on.
All right, Liz?
Remind me not to leave the room again.
Say again.
Remind me not to leave the room again.
Okay. Okay, Doc. You back with us?
Yeah.
We're
going nowhere.
We were there a minute ago. Okay.
Yeah.
Can you stand up, Liz? Because you're on that side, isn't it?
I'm all right. I'm fine.
Well,
no, okay. You're not.
Can you walk about 4 or 5 paces forward? Are you like somebody sleepwalking, to be honest?
I'm fine.
Okay, no problem.
What's the last thing you remember about this?
Just listening to you lot talking.
Yeah, okay.
Did you...
And the dog bark, I heard the dog bark, and then...
Do you recollect anything?
No.
The dog barked like 4 or 5 minutes ago.
No. I'm just doing... I thought I was just doing a long talk.
No.
What was it?
Yeah, your eyes were wide open, but you weren't responding to anything.
Guys, it isn't something that happens very often. It really isn't.
No. Yeah. Because he's shouting. So.
Yeah, something.
I felt really sick and I felt really dizzy.
Yeah, you really, really just looked sick. Really. I'll have to put my bonnet on you again, like I did before the boat and also that time.
Just one question. What did you feel first, sick or dizzy?
Sick.
Right. Solar plexus, yeah.
I've had that trouble all the way.
Oh, you've had that all the way, yeah, early on.
Okay.
And then I felt sick, and then I felt tired.
Yeah. At the moment, the sensitives are just doing an MOT, just to make sure that there's no lasting effects, and to try if there is any area of weakness that they can detect on this, they will try and group protect. It isn't something that happens very often. I can only remember it happening one other time.
Yeah.
And I've been with the team for over 3 years. So it is, normally it is a case of divide and conquer, if it's something. If it is something malevolent, which as yet I don't think they've determined, but it is, they tend to separate the sensitives. So even within that,
on the way we answered, they come in one straight out on, that's why.
It's only Josie, and Josie, you're still kind of, you're on the later stages of training, aren't you, to try and,
early on I got it, I didn't.
Try and get your full skill.
I'm not far back,
Without being rude, you're kind of in the latter stages of your training with mediumship and things like that, aren't you? So
I've always been, always seen things since a young age. But I went to classes to bring it more out and understand it all. But I do witchcraft and everything. Not bad witchcraft.
I was just saying how whatever's happened has divided the mediums up. And it was only you left in here, wasn't it? And so there wasn't.
That's why I ended up having to
because it seems to be, in my personal opinion, I'm not a thingy on this. They've taken the stronger male aspects out and then picking on the females. So that's how I see it.
I've been drinking.
Of course, I'm not kind of. Matt would know a lot more on it than I would. That's just my perspective on it.
Interesting.
It was interesting.
It's when you split up.
That's what I'm saying. It's happened. Every time these guys are together, have you noticed?
But also the fact that Matt was as far as we was now in a different room.
We're in that situation again where we've got Talbingo.
Because you were on your own. Yes.
If you understand that.
So,
but this time I didn't feel any. Normally, if you notice very close, you can see them. You feel the measure on your back or
Like somebody having an epileptic fit without shakes. You were just transfixed.
What is that?
Where I'm kneeling now, you were basically staring at the floor, you weren't blinking, and you didn't blink for 2 minutes.
I was going to say, she was blinking quite a bit towards the end.
She wasn't blinking, she was looking roughly where I am now, and she was just staring at it, and she wasn't blinking, and when we were talking, she was like, there was no interaction, so she was like, the lights are on, there's nobody home syndrome.
When she leaned back, this is how, because we're such a small group.
Yeah, that's when she leaned against the wall, I thought she'd passed out.
We kind of know each other's traits, and so we immediately switch on when we know that a behaviour pattern isn't normal. So I've had it once before, apparently, where I got overshadowed. I remember something completely different. Matt was there, and Matt played with something else.
That's what we were asking for.
It's just everybody's cottoned on to what's going on with me, and just like we can cotton on with what's happening. That vibrating noise is air coming.
It's got vibrating.
No, but I think I know what it is. It's the as the wind's blowing through a very small space of perspex, it's vibrating like a cone.
Just everybody talking and calling out.
Well, we asked for someone.
Well, next time, woman, bloody answer.
When I looked at you, that's when you went. Because I thought you'd fallen over.
Because you were at a funny angle, I thought you'd completely gone over.
That's all I heard, was Liz slumped over.
I've got no recognition of you going in there, I thought you were still
here. I've gone in there, when Andy said about someone going in there, I went in there and sat down, and Claire came into me, and Chris came there.
Just to check, it's not a reflection thing, does somebody look over there towards that door?
No, it wasn't, you hadn't got the torch on when I just seen it.
No, I'm just saying, it might be somebody with the torch.
It's not my IR, is it? Nothing
about the IR with your eyes, but even in reflection, you have to throw a filter.
Okay, would you like to take a break and regather yourself?
No, we'll have a break. We'll have a drink.
I think it would have taken a little bit out of you. Have a drink. Well, what I would suggest, just out of safety side of things, regroup downstairs, reevaluate how we approach the next area. Because being caught on words.
If we go downstairs and just have a 5 or 10 minute break.